Kamusta everyone, I'm Sizz, and Divinity Original Sin Enhanced Edition can be a very complex game. And while I do have a video talking about Divinity Original Sin in a beginner-style format, there are certain people who are looking for more than just that. Air Dirge spells can be a difficult skill line to understand. Unlike other RPGs, Air Dirge spells are halfway used to both mages and frontline fighters, as half of the skill lines present in its line are skills obviously made for getting up close to the enemy through movement, invisibility, or by teleporting them from one spot to the other. It works the best with the Hydrosophist skill line, and it's what I would suggest getting if you plan on building a hybrid mage, or just for supplementary skills for your warriors and rogues. And so, as promised, here's how to play Divinity Original Sin Enhanced Edition Air Dirge Guide. The Air Dirge skill line is all about air magic. This involves lightning and wind manipulation. These skills are focused on character placement, maneuverability, stuns, and the removal of environmental effects present in the battlefield. Like I said, it's best used with the Hydrosophist skill line, as most stuns and damage skills present in the Air Dirge line blends and combines well with it, and even requires it to work substantially better. If you want to focus on outmaneuvering enemies while at the same time stopping them right in their tracks, the Air Dirge skill line would be the most effective way to go. Skills unlike talents can be acquired by reading the appropriate skill book with the same name, and can be forgotten if need be. All of them are useful when used in the right circumstance, and it's one of the many ways that will set your character apart from each other. There are 16 Air Dirge skills available in the game, and it's best that you think about this carefully before teaching them into your character. This is because at max Air Dirge ability level, you'll only be able to obtain 6 novice skills, 4 adept skills, and 2 master skills. It's a weird limitation, but just enough to give it a sense of carefulness. And in true how to play style, I'll be going over them one by one, starting with the name, what it does, and what I think about it. Let's begin. Avatar of Storms makes the target immune to being electrified or stunned. When an ally with this buff is attacked by a melee character, that character has a chance of being stunned as a result. Very situational, but very useful when the need arises. Since you can freely take 6 out of the 7 skills on the Novice Air Dirge skill line, I would highly suggest taking this, as there is no other skills that might be as useful. More on that later. Bitter Cold freezes a target. Extremely helpful on the starting zones of the game, as you will need every single crowd control that you can get. Crowd control is the key when it comes to combat, and it should always be your priority when engaging in one. Freezing the target will cause the frozen status effect and will prevent them from moving or attacking. It disappears in a few turns or would disappear immediately when hit by skills on the Pyromancy skill line. Blitzbolt shoots a bolt of electricity that deals a certain amount of air damage depending on your intelligence attribute. This would be your main damage spell in the first few hours of the game and will electrify any water or blood puddles near the target. This will result in the stun, which would also crowd control anyone stepping on it, allies included. Shocking Touch. Electrify a target at arm's length. Again, this would deal a certain amount of air damage depending on your intelligence attribute. All, if not most, air dirge damage are calculated via your intelligence attributes, so just assume that whenever I say damage, it would be based on that. It would be weird if I keep on saying the exact same thing for every skill. Anyways, Shocking Touch deals air damage to the target, but with the caveat of the target having to be at arm's length from you. Great for melee mages, which doesn't exist, or should not exist, as that would be very, very bad. It can be useful for a very specific mage build, but if you're going as a ranged mage like normal mages, do not take this. You won't even use it. Teleportation. Throw an item or character up high and drop it to the ground, dealing crushing damage. This is extremely, extremely useful and helpful, not just for combat, but for also just plain exploring. There are a multitude of items that are away from your reach, and there will be no other way to get it unless using this skill. Take note that this will also damage anything or anyone that you use it on, and as such, I recommend not using this on your companions aside from the ones you made on character creation. Using them on the companions that you meet while playing the game will cause them to leave the party. Thunder Jump. Jump from one target to the other, hitting a maximum of 2 targets, stunning them, and dealing air damage. Great skill, not really all that useful for mages unless when in very specific situations, but extremely useful as a supplementary skill for warriors and rogues, as this would add some extra maneuverability which melee fighters need a lot of, and will also deal damage and will stun anyone you pass through. I can't stress this enough, this is a very good skill to have. Wind of Change, cures petrification, slowed, and stunned. Very self-explanatory, useful when the need arises. Next is the Adept Heritage skill line. You can only get 4 out of 5 skills it has to offer. All of them are useful, but it depends on you which one you want to leave out. Air Absorption Shield, enchant self or an ally with an air shield. The air shield absorbs air damage until it breaks. The thing about this skill is that it would only protect you from air damage, specifically that type of skill alone. This makes the skill very situational, and you know me when it comes to situational skills. I mostly don't take it. This one depends on you though. I can see myself maybe needing this at some point in the game, but I would just personally take the other 4 skills. Head Vice. It's a target skill, meaning you won't miss and it will deal air damage. Obviously. This would be your second go-to ability in the skill line and is recommended if you want to deal more damage, which you should. Invisibility. Becomes invisible for a short time. Very self-explanatory, it makes you invisible. Keyword, you, the caster, not someone else. You. And as such, this makes it useful for escaping and relocating. Great for a mage, extremely useful for a rogue. Would I recommend using up all those ability points just to get this one? Yeah, it's okay. I mean, it's not bad. And you'll be using this all the time anyways. Summon Air Elemental. Summons an air elemental. This will act as the 5th party member in your team and is a great addition to the team in general. This will do more damage and will also act as cannon fodder when needed. Don't be afraid to summon her right before the fight. Tornado. Removes surfaces from the battlefield, reveals invisible characters, and clears warm, burning, and hastened. This will remove all surfaces, blood, oil, fire, poison, water, or any combination of all those 5. This will also remove fog-like surfaces such as smoke and, you know, fog. Extremely useful when the need arises, and although it doesn't really do damage, it does clean up the battlefield, useful for both combat and out of combat. Next is Master Skills. This is a big one. They are game-changing and powerful skills, and you can take 2 out of the 4 available. And while I do say that for Master Skills, for Heritage specifically, it's obvious which 3 are the most useful. It's gonna be a difficult pick, so think about this carefully. Chain Lightning shoots out a stunning bolt of lightning that forks up to 5 times in a 7-meter radius, and deals air damage to each target. This is very good. This will stun 5 targets, making them unable to move or attack, does damage, and will only target enemies specifically. A great starting skill for a fight, and you can always rely on this to turn around fights. Make Invisible. Sets the invisible status on a target. It's like invisible, but for other people. I gotta be honest here, I kept thinking about a situation that I would need this on, and then I remembered I don't like situational skills, so yeah, don't take this, it's a waste unless you know what you're doing. Nether Swap. A great utility skill that would make 2 characters, whether enemy or not, to switch places. It's basically teleportation 2.0, but more interesting. You'll mostly use this to teleport your tanky melee character at the back line while at the same time bring their ranged squishy character in the front line, ready to get killed by either your rogue or your secondary warrior, ranger, or whatever you have available. Storm. Creates a lightning storm that randomly picks 8 to 10 targets and deals air damage. This will deal a ton of damage in one area and is best used for tightly packed enemies. Take note that the damage is in air damage, so it will also stun those 8 to 10 targets when hit, causing a massive crowd control. What else do you want more? Suppose it to say, it's an absolutely great skill to have. And that's the Heritage skill line. Kumusta everyone, I'm Sizz, and if you don't know, I will be doing every single skill line in the game. It's actually very fun and exciting for me because it's been a while since I touched the first game of the original Sin series. I'm very excited to make more and I really hope that you'll stay with me as well. Next video is about skills that would take advantage of the Heritage line. And that's Hydra Sophist. Like the video if you don't dislike it, and dislike if you don't like it. Share it with your friends, and if you do like it, consider subscribing to the Phantom Heart for more, and click on that notification bell to be reminded of my future videos. I'm Sizz, and thank you for watching.